Hey guys, Kaidaski here, and today I have a slightly different kind of video for you. Anybody who knows me in real life knows I have a real passion for shooting. In the past, I've competed at regional and national level in several different trap disciplines as a junior. And though I no longer compete at the top level, it still remains a passion of mine. However, as a hobby, it's very expensive and shooting grounds are few and far between. Ever since getting into virtual reality, I knew the platform could be perfect for the right game to simulate shooting clays. Over the last couple of years, I've stumbled across a couple games on Steam, but nothing has quite felt right. For me, the perfect game would have to be realistic and challenging. Every game I tried felt either too easy, too arcadey, or didn't quite nail the physics. A couple of options felt promising, but they seemed to have been abandoned. However, last month, I stumbled across a true hidden gem. The physics feels spot on, just like real life. There are loads of disciplines and modes you can shoot, either alone or with friends in real time. But best of all, it's available on App Lab, so you can play it on standalone Quest. So without further ado, here is my review for Clay Hunt VR. First of all, this game covers a lot of different disciplines. Here I'm shooting Olympic skeet or international skeet, but you also have American skeet available as an option. For newer shooters, you can adjust the difficulty settings to have slower targets to give you more time to react. Or if you're like me and you like a challenge, put it on professional difficulty and experience true-to-life physics. If you prefer trap shooting, you have plenty of options available, with variations such as American trap, international trap, and double trap. Just as with skeet, you can adjust the difficulty level to match your ability, ranging from beginner with nice, slow, easy targets, to professional for the full-blown realism experience. Both trap and skeet also have an infinite mode. In infinite mode, you'll receive a mixture of targets across different disciplines, and you'll keep shooting until you miss. And this is where the game's competitive element starts to come into it, with worldwide leaderboards showing off your top scores. In Clay Hunt VR, just as in real life, the truest challenge of a shooter's ability lies in sporting. Sporting layouts consist of multiple stands with different targets on each stand. The magic of sporting is that no two layouts are the same, so you're going to have to adapt on the fly. As of this recording, Clay Hunt VR currently has 3 full sporting layouts of 60 targets each, with plans to add more in the future. The sporting layouts in this game are very well designed, with a mixture of really challenging and creative targets to keep you on your toes. If you consider yourself more of a huntsman than a competitive shooter, worry not, because there are game modes for you. At the time of recording, there are currently modes for both wild pigeon and driven pheasant. While these modes do offer a great fun simulation experience, there are also some really fast-paced and wacky arcade modes. Clay Hunt VR gives you plenty of options to customize the game to suit you, providing options to allow you to set up to use a gun stock instead of using your controllers alone. Other options, such as shot trace and pattern feedback, can give you a training tool to help you develop your shooting by providing accurate feedback on exactly where your shot landed. You can also completely customize your shooting style by choosing from one of 4 guns. In all game modes, you can choose between an over and under, pump action, side by side, or semi-automatic. You can also customize your gun by adding a high rib, or by changing the chokes in the barrels to affect how wide the spread is. If there's one way to make shooting even more fun and enjoyable, it's by shooting with a friend. At the time of recording, Clay Hunt VR offers multiplayer modes for pheasants, pigeons, and sporting layouts, with plans to implement multiplayer for skeet and trap in the coming weeks. Earlier today, I was lucky enough to hop online and shoot with the game's developer, Alexi. Not only was this great fun, it also gave me a chance to ask him a few questions about where the game's heading. Cool.
Nice pair.
Pull.
Pull. Nice pair.
Oh man, I suck today. I'm feeling so nervous.
It's the nerves of shooting on video.
Yeah.
Pull. So where do you see the future of this game going then?
Yeah, I know you're actually just about to say it, like, now I feel the pressure, and obviously you do as well when we are recording this, and so I would hope to see this kind of live competition part of the game grow with the community, and there could be even like participants watching the shootout, and
that would be cool.
And maybe even streaming these competitions and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But, yeah, maybe that's like next year, or I need to first get the kind of basic features done, and maybe these kind of multiplayer modes where you don't have to play at the same time, but can participate on these kind of monthly cups, like in the mobile game.
Yeah. I think that playing live together definitely adds a new level to it. You know, you're watching the other guy. Oh no, he got all six, which means I need to get all six really to keep up. And you know, it makes it so much more fun. It's good.
Yeah.
All right. So I need to hit two to draw. Let's go. Right. Pull. The pressure, the nerves. Pull! Yeah, there we go.
Oh,
pull! Ah, 45 to 43. We've both shot better before.
Yeah, but it's a different thing to shoot on this kind of pressure.
Oh yeah, and knowing it was first game of the day for both of us, so it's not bad. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Later today, I'll be uploading the full round of sporting I shot with Alexi, so you can check that out later on. Also, for a bit of a bonus, we did 10 minutes of pigeon shooting together, which was great fun. My thoughts then, and I would strongly, strongly recommend this game to anyone who enjoys shooting or anyone with a good competitive edge to them. This is 100% skill-based gaming. Even if you've never shot before in real life, give this a go and you will get better. I've genuinely found that practicing this game a lot has made my real life shooting so much better. I've been beating personal bests lately, despite not shooting competitively for nearly 10 years. If you do want to get serious about this game and get the true immersive experience, I recommend getting a VR gun stock. The one you see me using here is a Sanlaki. A stock like this greatly improves your accuracy and really adds to the immersion. Recently, a company called Texture VR actually created a gun stock specifically for this game to truly replicate the shotgun experience. I'm yet to pick one of these up, but I'm bound to eventually. This looks great. Also, in the last couple of days, I've recently set up a new Discord for players of this game. We're starting small, but eventually would like to start hosting competitions. For links and more information, check the description below. But for now, that's it from me. I'm gonna go and shoot some stuff. Take care.